fuckers, and welcome back to my YouTube channel. I hope you are having an amazing night. I, for one, am very sorry for how my hair looks right now. I just got out of the gym, I just got a shower, and honestly, I want to go to bed and I don't want to put a bunch of hairspray in it, so please bear with this mess. I agree. Horrible. Okay, anyway, on with the video. Also, Free Britney, have to put this on screen because it is something that needs to motherfucking happen. Okay, so in today's video, we are going to be talking about Colleen Ballinger, who has wrapped herself up in yet another controversy. Now, this is another example that we're seeing in which Colleen is, as of right now anyway, not addressing this. She tweeted something earlier and a lot of people were responding to said tweet with, you know, can you acknowledge this? Can you apologize for this? And those tweets are now no longer there. So it seems that Colleen is going to take the approach, again, as of right now, it may change and I hope it does change, of not addressing things, ignoring them, and just letting the people be angry and moving on, and eventually they'll get tired and they'll stop talking about it. And this time, it is so weird because it's just like Colleen's own fans that are so upset by this and so just kind of in awe. And that has to do with the overall topic of pregnancy and fertility. And that's a very, very, very sensitive topic, especially Colleen would understand that. You know, Colleen has had things happen in the past, she has her son, she has, you know, she's pregnant right now, and congratulations for that. And so this is a woman who knows very much so the hardships with pregnancy on your body, and also, while she is not directly, you know, affected by infertility and having to use IVF and, you know, struggling with having children naturally, and naturally, I mean, in terms of you and your partner, it is something that people struggle with, and it is not something to laugh at, it's not something to joke at, and there are stigmas out there against people who, you know, aren't able to carry their own children, or who aren't fertile, you know, who are desperately wanting their children too, and there's nothing wrong with them, because they're not able to do that, you know, there's other routes that they have to take. And for someone who has came online so much saying how easy it is for her to get pregnant, we saw this with her last pregnancy, she said how, you know, it just happened so quickly, and her, you know, this is something that has been a narrative with Colleen, that she has said, you know, how easy it is for her to get pregnant. So for someone in that position to then come online making fun of people who struggle with that is, quite frankly, the most disgusting thing ever. And especially, I don't know why you would be so idiotic to put this out there on your platform. So this happened on a podcast that Colleen did with her husband. So this is not a live stream, this is not a live broadcast in any way, this is a podcast that is filmed, edited, and uploaded. So this was said on camera, edited, allowed to stay in, and uploaded, and has now affected so many people. And it's not just affected people as in it's a joke. It's affected people because Colleen refers to people and, you know, babies from IVF as broken. You know, you're broken. You had to have your child that way. This is something that was said and kept in and published. And of course the backlash for that is immense. Of course that has offended, upset, and left so many people. What's the word you can use in that situation? It's so ridiculous anyway that this happened, and I just can't believe that this happened with someone who so overtly on her platforms is so, you know, pregnancy positive, and how beautiful is it that we can all have babies, and how beautiful is it that, you know, my body can do this and your body can do this, and, you know, there's, we'll not get into it, but so many underlying levels of whenever it comes to pregnancy, like fat phobia with Colleen, which let's not touch on that, but it's just so weird that someone can be so body positive and, you know, so, oh my god, it's so amazing that the human body can do this, in the same breath that they're willing to refer to IVF babies and people who have to have babies that way as broken. Let's see the clip and let's see the response. So if I go on Twitter right here, this is what I've been getting tagged on all day today. So a tweet from the user of mom3nt, your username is far too long, I love you, don't know who you are, username is long, not reading that entire thing out. So they said, apparently the idea that using IVF means you're broken and that's hilarious. So here we go, here we have the clip of Colleen and her husband in which they say that. So let's listen to this.
Number one says, if you walk out of the house with two babies, people will ask how they were conceived. That's very weird. They're saying that everyone is ridiculously interested in knowing if you had IVF. Like if it
was
like... Oh,
because it's so common with that?
Yeah. So when you take the babies out...
Out for a stroll, people are going to be
you,
like...
You broken? I'm just kidding. No one's broken if they can't do that.
No, you know, yeah.
It's weird that... Colleen, I know you're watching this one-on-one. It's weird that your mind went there. It's weird that your mouth went there. And it's weird that you put that out there. Eric wasn't going there. And something that's important to note, that from my knowledge, and what I'm seeing in all these threads, Eric, Colleen's husband, is an IVF baby. Colleen, this is... This is not a laughing, this is not a joke, this is like, so your, his parents have gone through being broken that they can't house their own baby, Colleen. And the funniest thing is, she knows what she said was wrong because she apologizes for it immediately, laughing while saying the apology and right after it, but chose to keep this in, you know, keep it in. And this has been a conversation at hand with Colleen Ballinger for years now. And so this tweet was resurfaced by The Garden Cat. It is from the 8th of February, 2019. And it's important to note as well that basically you can use this with any of Colleen's content for like the past couple of years whenever she, you know, said that she wasn't going to turn into like a mommy vlogger or, you know, putting her son on her channel because she wanted to respect his privacy. But then when it gave views, mommy channel... this person said, I have so much respect for this woman, but seriously, think of the ladies that cannot get pregnant or are trying to get pregnant, IVF. They'd love their body to look like this. Sorry, something I had to say. So it is these videos from Colleen, how pregnancy ruined my body, and then this is the thumbnail, and then a video that says what pregnancy and birth did to my vagina and breasts. Now, I have never been pregnant. I cannot speak for how a pregnant woman feels in that instance. So actually, I'm not going to... criticize Colleen for, you know, having opinions on what pregnancy did to her body. I understand that people are, you know, saying that this is what people want so desperately, but I don't think that, you know, X's out her personal opinion of it. But it is important to note that for years now, Colleen has been getting called out for being insensitive, at least, and these comments have been raised to her, and she's kind of just pushed them off. So it has been a topic at hand that, you know, her response to pregnancy and the impact that she has on her platform and to be a bit more sensitive, and she's never really done anything with that. So important to note as well. Okay, so if I go back on the Garden Cat's profile, and they have been talking about this. So this first person who posted about this, some of the responses are, so we have Cody Rance. One of my best friends can't have children without help due to medical condition, so I don't think it's funny to joke about using IVF. This is extremely upsetting to me, and I think she knew it was a bad joke, trying to cover it up really quickly. And it's like, she covered it up really quickly, but she obviously thought it was funny enough to keep it in the actual podcast. People are saying it's not funny, not the move, and it's like, people just cannot believe people are saying, bro, fuck Colleen Ballinger, I'm very disappointed in Colleen. Colleen's own fans are doing this yet again, she is not addressing it. Someone said, Colleen, you were crying about pregnancy on your channel and struggling to conceive. Take several seats. This is how other people feel. So, it's... Here we go. Having famous person Colleen Ballinger vocalize what I think about myself during my darkest moments in my IVF journey and then laughing about it to millions of people is hurtful beyond compare. It's taken me a long time to try and convince myself that I'm not broken. And a lot of people are responding saying, as someone who cannot get pregnant because I had PCOS and infertility issues, this is insulting and disgusting. Wow, what a topic to joke about. Also adding, I'm kidding, after calling people broken doesn't prevent them from feeling bad. What an insensitive comment. Gosh. Infertility is an incredibly sensitive subject. This is disgusting. So no one is on Colleen's side with this. So it's interesting to me that she's still choosing to remain silent on this. Now, I do think it is going to get to a point where she has to address this because her own fans are turning on her. And I know from experience, that's something that like is so far beyond the point for her. Regardless of general public's opinion, she doesn't care. Whenever her fans get angry, that's when she gets stressed. So, we can expect it addressed soon. And I honestly, do not care about her intentions about apologizing. Just apologize because you've upset and triggered so many of your own fans. Like, I don't know how sick you have to be. So, someone said, my twin sister and I were born on IVF. My mom had multiple miscarriages and has lost multiple children after every childbirth before us. I hate when people make disparaging comments like this. You have no idea what these people go through. This is enough. This is so damn hilarious. This is worse knowing that her own husband is a product of IVF. This joke is not funny or clever, and it's at the expense of everyone who has infertility issues. It's just mean. It's at the expense of her mother-in-law and father-in-law and her own husband. What the fuck is wrong with her? So we have this, and again, people are just really, really, really calling this out. And a lot of people are saying that, hey, you know, why are you coming for Colleen? A lot of people are just pushing this off because she's pregnant right now, and I guess a pregnant woman cannot get any criticism in the entire world. Ooh. Okay, so a lot of people are saying, on top of this, that, you know, Colleen has struggled with losing a baby in the past, which is extremely devastating, and heart goes out to Colleen. And people are using that as a way of being like, okay, she's allowed to, her own fans have been responding to people who have been distraught over being called broken by their favorite person in the entire world. And the fans are responding saying, hey, she's allowed to say this because this happened to her. This incredibly devastating event happened to her. Again, heart goes out to her. So she's allowed to make this joke, which is not the logic, and a lot of people as well have been referencing this clip, which again is just really, really, really weird. It's called My Husband Wrote Me a Love Song, and it was uploaded 3rd of March, and this timestamp was sent to me multiple times on Discord in reference to that conversation, and it's Colleen's own husband who had like wrote a song using reviews of their podcast, and one of it, this was it.
Edit. Also, I'm so sorry about your miscarriage.
Oh my God!
Five stars.
Oh my God! At least we got 5 stars out of that. Oh no!
Anyways, this is just like so fucking idiotic. I don't know how. What's the word I'm looking for that's nice? I don't know how ignorant you have to be to say it, put it out there, and not expect people to get angry at it. And to those who were upset by this comment, no, if you have to use IVF or you are an IVF baby, you're not broken or your parents are not broken. It goes without fucking saying, we don't have to say this, but apparently, people use their platforms to push that narrative even further, which all of these people struggle with. I'm very curious to see how her fans defend her in the comments of this video. It's my favorite pastime, reading how they twist things. So, jump along for the ride as well. Colleen, again, I know you're watching this. Address it. It's not drama. Address it. Apologize. Say why you said it, why you posted it, and why you've been silent whenever you've been getting backlash for the past 24 hours. And by the way, you being pregnant does not stop you from getting criticism or having to address being critiqued. Lord. Bye.